Hi guys, Stephanie Kojak here and welcome back to my channel. This is Thanos over here. Say hi. Oh, there he is. Say hi. Anyway, that's Thanos. He's going to be part of today's festivities and probably be really, really annoying. But anyway, to break the cycle of fear, we have to know and recognize its voice. And you can always identify that fear is speaking within you by these two indicators. First, the voice of fear is always changing. And second, it is always rooted in scarcity. That means never having enough. The voice of fear will constantly change its mind by focusing on one problem and then the next.
There are at least 37 things for Riley to be scared of right now.
Then it will tell you that the cause of all these problems is that there's never enough. Never enough money, never enough time, resources, support. And the most sinister thing about the voice of fear is that oftentimes it's actually rooted in truth. Although fear layers truth with unnecessary complexity and excuses. Yes, right now times are changing fast, really, really fast. But it has always been that way. And what fear is doing is focusing in on the problems that the change is creating in our everyday lives and denying the opportunities and solutions that are present within this current situation. So when you take a moment to really listen, you will hear the voice of fear within. And once you recognize it, all that needs to be done is to simply sit with this voice. Fear is a normal and a valuable human response to uncertainty. We need to accept that it's okay to feel scared and uneasy and anxious and worried and angry. If you deny these feelings for any reason, then you're feeding the cycle. These emotions are not bad or wrong. All they are signals letting you know that fear is active within you right now. You can think of these emotions like that movie Inside Out by Pixar. And you have within you these little beings that do the best they can to guide you through life based on what they know.
I'm sadness.
Oh, hello. I'm joy. So, I just want to fix that. Thanks. And that was just the beginning. Headquarters only got more crowded from there.
Very nice. Okay, looks like you got this. Very good.
Well, that's sharp turn. Ah, look out!
That's fear. He's really good at keeping Riley safe.
Easy, huh? I'm back! Oh, we're good.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
And we're back.
One of the most powerful practices to transmute the energy and momentum or the cycle of fear is to just sit with it. Give it space to be within you. Almost as if you are sitting with a good friend who is sad. You would never judge that friend. You would never say that their feelings are wrong. So why do we do it to ourselves? You would do your best to comfort your friend by being with them, listening and accepting their stories and their feelings, knowing full well that this won't last forever.
I'm sorry they took your rocket. They took something that you loved. It's gone forever.
Sadness, don't make him feel worse.
Sorry.
It's all I had left of Riley.
I bet you and Riley had great adventures.
Oh, they were wonderful. Once we flew back in time, we had breakfast twice that day.
Sadness!
It sounds amazing. I bet Riley liked it.
Oh, she did. We were best friends.
Simply sitting with that person, compassionately, without trying to stop that cycle, is the most powerful healing balm of all. So be that for yourself. Or call someone who you trust that can hold that space for you while you're going through that heightened phase, whether it lasts for a few minutes or a few hours. And this will help it pass much faster and much sooner than later. So, most importantly is to acknowledge the fear and the sadness and for it to be okay to feel that way. It will lift the heaviness in its own time, rather than trying to deny it and be positive and as a result feeding the cycle even further. The second way to activate a new cycle of thought and emotion within you is to lessen your time frame.
When one can see no future, all one can do is the next right thing.
The next right thing is for me to go.
Take it down to day by day or even hour by hour if you need to, especially in times like this when the outcome is so uncertain. We don't know when we're going to be back to normal. And in this shorter time frame, do each thing in that day or in that hour with absolute care and attention. Why? Because the future is only an infinite number of probability distributions based on what you're thinking and feeling and doing right now today. And the greatest influence we have on our own future is to take care of today.
All right, everyone, fresh start. We are going to have a good day, which will turn into a good week, which will turn into a good year, which turns into a good life.
So start by breaking down your day and lessen your time frame. Create a schedule and an outline of what needs to be done today. Don't worry about tomorrow. Don't worry about next week. Don't worry about next year. It may only be one or two things in this day. And these things are important. Otherwise, they wouldn't be on your list. And you must commit to doing each of these things with great attention and care. And each person's list is going to be different because some people are still working. Some people have got to raise kids. There's lots of things going on. But for example, for your own soul, you might put something like baking a cake on that list. All that you need to do when you bake this cake is to give each step in this process your loving, caring, undivided attention. There are a lot of ways to make the same cake. You can shove ingredients and mix it and chuck it in the oven, or you can take your time to measure it perfectly, sift the flour, mix it gently, all the while appreciating the work it took to get all these ingredients to you. You might crack an egg and thank the chicken at the farmer, and you can fully take in each smell and texture, noticing how each step transforms the mixture. You might notice how the heat of the oven warms your skin or how the smell of the cake being cooked drifts into every corner of your home. Trust me, that cake is going to taste so good. And this all may sound stupid to you, but I challenge you. I lovingly challenge you to just try it for yourself and find out for yourself whether or not this actually works. In times like these, we are almost forced to slow down and come back to the present moment. There's an old saying, throw some gold on the floor. And it comes from the bloodlines of ancient storytellers and healers. And it means to throw away some words of a story in order to make it stronger. There is so much power in slowing down, throwing some stuff on the floor, stopping and looking and smelling and tasting. When you throw some gold on the floor, when you shorten your time frame and your focus, you get right down to the bones of everything in your life. And that's where pleasure is. When you shorten your time frame, there remains no time to be afraid because your heart and your mind and your spirit are too full of everything that's in front of you. And when you do this, your day will be good. And the next right move will reveal itself to you in divine timing. And the next day will be the result of all the energy that you put into this day. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe if you're new here. And I'll see you in the next one, guys. Bye. Say bye, Thanos. Say bye. Oh.
What will be, will be. And so it goes, and it always goes on and on and on and on and on.